Hello everyone, this is Laura Nickerson from GoEngineer. You're in manufacturing or engineering, and you often receive CAD data from business partners for feedback. One day you receive an email from noreply@3dexperience.3ds.com that contains a hyperlink, or a customer or a colleague sends you an email with a hyperlink to 3dexperience.3ds.com. What is this? It's not spam. Your business partner is using SOLIDWORKS on the 3DEXPERIENCE platform, and they want your feedback on some CAD data using the web-based 3D CAD and Document Markup tool. The 3DEXPERIENCE platform enables individuals to collaborate with external resources on design data without requiring them to download and install software. You, as the external resource, do not need any software licenses to conduct a file review and provide feedback. You just need a simple, free login to the 3DEXPERIENCE platform. Click the link in the email. You are prompted to log into the 3DEXPERIENCE platform. You can log in with an existing 3DEXPERIENCE or SOLIDWORKS ID, or create a 3DEXPERIENCE account. Fill out the information, accept the terms, click Register, and log in. You create your 3DEXPERIENCE account once, and now you'll be able to access anyone's 3DEXPERIENCE data sent via a link. After logging in, a browser window opens to the 3D model displayed in a web-based markup tool. You are linked to the model that is stored in the 3DEXPERIENCE platform. Let's see how we can interact with the file. Notice on the top right, you have the option to download the file. In this case, it is a 3D XML file. You can receive neutral file formats, SLD PRT files, 2D PDF, PNG, DWG, or DXF. The action bar found at the bottom of the viewport has two tabs, View and Tools. The View tab provides commands to navigate the 3D space and change the display of the model. Fit All In fits the entire model in the viewport. You can move the camera with the left mouse button with Pan, Rotate, and Zoom. In View Modes, you have the option to change the display style with presets or individual controls for shading and edges. In Default Appearances, you can display the model with material properties. You can control the visibility of reference geometry. You can change the background. And lastly, you can toggle on or off perspective. X closes View Modes. In standard views, use the arrows to cycle through the orthographic views, or spin the model, and you can reorient the model using the isometric view. Double-click will exit standard views. The Tools tab provides commands to review, manipulate, and mark up the content. Hide Show hides the selected components. In the side toolbar, you can Show All, Swap Visibility, and Isolate. Swap Visibility is a toggle between showing the hidden or visible components. Isolate will show only the selected components. Since this is an assembly, you have the Explode option. Use the slider to adjust the spacing. Click the icon again to collapse the view. Activate Clipping creates a cross-section. Use the arrows and rings to relocate the cutting plane. Use the toolbar to change the cutting plane or invert the cut side. Right-click the cutting plane to align the view normal to the cutting plane. Activate Clipping toggles off the cross-section. You can add measurements or dimensions to the markup. Green check completes the command. Filters help select specific items. Here is a distance measurement. You have additional options to create multiple measurements of the same type of dimensions, or create chain or stacked dimensions. With multiple measurements, you can continue creating distance dimensions. Green check completes the measure command. A right-click opens the Properties dialog box to change the display properties of a dimension or multiple dimensions. You have predefined flag colors to communicate a condition, you can change the font size, and you have local control over the fill, outline, and text colors and transparency. You can drag the dimensions to a new location, and the eraser deletes the selected item. The annotation commands allows you to sketch on the model. A side panel provides options to exit the annotation tool, freehand sketch on the model. Joining the endpoint to the starting point will default to a standard shape. The eraser removes individual sketches, and the annotation color can be changed for the next sketch. Starting a sketch on a face locates the annotation on that face. The text annotation command displays a text box in the center of the screen. You can drag the text box to a new location. Type in the text box, the trash can will cancel the command, and click outside the text box to finish the command. You can have multiple views with annotations to fully communicate your feedback. In this side view, you have the same options to add sketch annotations and text annotations. You can edit the text by selecting it again and click the text to make modifications. Click outside the text box to finish the command. You can resize the text by dragging on a corner. Now there are two views with annotations. The annotation tour command cycles through the annotation views. The feedback is complete. To send it back to the 3D Experience user, use Share as Comment. The comments panel opens on the right. All the views with annotations are captured, packaged up, and added to the comments field in that one thumbnail image. You can also type a message in the comments field, and as a courtesy, indicate the number of annotation views. You must click the Send button. This posts the comment with images to the 3D Experience model. The 3D Experience user will get a notification through the 3D Experience platform that you have added a comment. Now, if they reply to your comment or update the model, they will inform you directly that an update is available. You will not receive another email from 3dexperience.3ds.com. The original email provided a link to the data. Given the word, you can refresh the browser to see the updates or re-click the link in the original email. The model opens in the web-based markup tool. The Comments tab will show the history of the comments posted to this model. If there is a thumbnail image, click the image to open the markup. Conduct your review of the modifications. If you add any more annotations to be shared with the 3D Experience user, you must use Share as Comment to add those views and annotations in the Comments field. Or you can simply reply or add a new comment. Click Send again to post your comment to the model. The 3D Experience user will receive another notification that a comment has been posted. And that's it. They're good to go. It is that simple. This has been Laura Nickerson with GoEngineer, showing you how super easy it is to collaborate with 3D Experience users. Thanks for watching.